Hey there, everyone. So today is Book Day, I guess we would say International Book Day. So I thought it would be fun to take a quick look at some phrases and expressions that we use in English that are related to books. So the first one here, we'll get right into it. The first one is read between the lines. So this phrase means that you should be able to draw a conclusion by reading between the lines, basically by figuring out what someone is insinuating or what people are trying to do, right? You should be able to draw your own conclusions by reading between the lines. So for example, your bosses maybe are getting stricter with you at work because maybe they want to fire you or want you to quit. So someone might say, hey, I think they're trying to get rid of you. You gotta read between the lines. Can't you tell what they're doing? It's like you have to make a conclusion based on the scenario and situation. Read between the lines. Next one is you can't judge a book by its cover. So this simply means that you can't make assumptions about people based on the way they look. So as an example, Tom never cleans up his appearance. He's always in gym clothes and never puts on anything that looks remotely dressy. Doesn't even look like he's tried. But Tom's a successful businessman, so that just goes to show you can't judge a book by its cover. The next one is you are an open book. So when someone's an open book, that means that that person doesn't try to hide anything, right? That person easy to read and easy to understand and isn't overly complicated. So you could say, my English teacher is an open book. His rules are very clear and his expectations are very clear. He's an open book. The next one is to be by the book. So this is a phrase that we use that means to follow the rules, basically. So for example, Jack is by the book. He won't even break the speed limit. That's how by the book Jack is. He follows all the rules. Another expression is the next chapter in my life. So we say the next chapter in our life when we're talking about the next phase in our life. So people will often say, I'm ready for the next chapter in my life. I'm ready for this chapter to be over and move on to the next chapter of my life. For example, when you turn 18, you usually start a new chapter in your life, right? The next expression is, I just want to make sure we are on the same page. So I want to make sure that we both have the same understanding or agree about something. I thought my teacher told us that we didn't have homework tonight, but I'm going to go ahead and send him an email and ask just to make sure we're on the same page. Next expression is, I'm not a mind reader. So when you read minds, it means you know what people think without them having to tell you what they're thinking, right? So an example of this might be your bosses being upset with you because you didn't do something the way they wanted you to do it. And you might tell them, hey, I'm not a mind reader, right? You never told me how to do this, so I can't read minds. What are your expectations here? The next phrase is to read someone like a book. So when you read someone like a book, you know what that person is doing, right? You know exactly what they're doing and you can predict their movements, basically. So this is common in sports, right? Someone might say if the defense is playing really well and the offense gets stopped, someone might say, oh wow, this player read the other guy like a book, right? He read him like a book. He knew exactly what he was going to do. So you can read someone like a book. And then another way we use the word book is to talk about running fast for some reason. We use this phrase to book it, right? So to book it means you run really fast. For example, I had to book it yesterday to catch the train because it was about to take off and I almost missed it. So I had to really book it. It means you had to run fast. We also use the word book as a verb, right? So you have book as a noun, which is what you read, but we also use it as a verb to book something, right? Like to book a hotel room, right? So we could say, I booked a trip as well. You could say, I booked a trip to Miami this weekend, or I booked two rooms in the hotel, but they only charged me for one. It means I reserved two, right? And then you could also use this phrase to talk about getting put in jail. We use it for criminals when they get put in jail. We'll say, this person got booked in the prison, or this person was booked in the county jail tonight. Anyway, I hope these expressions and phrases were useful, and happy book day. Let me know what your favorite book is in English, and we'll see you in the next lesson. Keep studying and keep learning.